Good morning, McAvenue School. Mr. Domina here handling the McAvenue morning announcements. Today is Wednesday, December 8th, 2021. Thank you once again for joining me for another edition of McAvenue's morning announcements. This is going to be an action-packed edition, lots of information to cover. Some of it is silly and some of it is going to be serious. So let's get to it. So as everyone knows, pardon me, today is an early release day at McAvenue. We are getting out at 1:30 p.m. today. I have sent two phone calls home and two emails home to your families. I put it out on the newsletter. I put it out on social media, the website. Your teachers have dojoed your families, so everybody knows that it's a 1:30 dismissal. And students, I know that you reminded your families as well. When you are going home and enjoying your afternoon, our teachers here at McAvenue will be learning to be better teachers. They will be spending some time getting lessons ready and working really hard to make sure that the rest of this time before the holiday break at McAvenue is going to be amazing. I just wanted to throw that out there to everyone. All right, let's start up like we always do by coming together as one unified collective school, showing our ultimate sign of respect by reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. So let's stand up, turn your voice off, get your right hand over your heart, make sure to face the flag in your classroom. If you happen to be out in the hallway and you hear my voice, just pause what you're doing, put your right hand over your heart, and remember it's completely fine to recite the Pledge of Allegiance even if you don't see the flag. Let's begin, everyone. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Nice job, everyone. And we are moving right into McAvenue's yoga pose of the week, the triangle. Let's get to it. We're starting in the standing mountain pose, which is our feet hip width apart and our hands down by our side. Remember, the movements are simple. We want to stretch our arms across like we're making the letter T. All right. At this particular time, you can go toward the left side or the right side. It does not matter because we're going to switch to do the opposite side that you didn't start with. I am going to go to the right side. I'm going to bend my right hand and arm toward my knee, and I'm feeling that stretch really on my left side. Take a deep breath in and release it. All right, let's go right back to the center, making the letter T, and now you're going to go to the opposite side. So in this case, my left hand is down by my knee, and I'm getting that good stretch on my right side. Take a deep breath in and release it. All right, go right back to the center. Take one more deep breath in and release it in that letter T position. Put your arms down by your side. And that is the triangle pose. So today is the last day that we're going to practice the triangle pose, pardon me, as one school. You can practice it tomorrow as an individual student or a classroom. And Friday, remember, no yoga because it's time for Friday dance party. So enjoy the triangle pose and use it when you need to use it. It is a great, great pose. Brand new pose, remember, starting on Monday. Nice job, everyone. We do have some birthdays to kind of talk about and celebrate. I believe that there's only one. Over the past 3 days, there's really only one birthday, all right? So on Tuesday, December 7th, which was yesterday, it was Edward's birthday in room 206. And if we take a look, today's Wednesday, December 8th, there's no birthdays. And Thursday, December 9th, there's no birthdays. So we will have a birthday on the Friday edition of Morning Announcements, and we will have two Saturday birthdays to celebrate, I believe. So let's get our birthday round of applause. Hands ready to go for Edward's birthday. That was yesterday. Here we go. All right. I saw Edward with his birthday crown on coming in from recess. I know that he had an amazing time in class with his friends, and hopefully he had fun with family and friends after school yesterday. More birthdays to come on the Friday edition of Morning Announcements. All right, McAvenue's joke of the day. It's that time where we try to have a little bit of fun. We try to crack the joke code and see if we can guess the answer. Let's just see what we have going on today. All right. Why don't penguins fly very well? So why don't penguins fly very well? Do you have your guess, prediction, or suggestion locked in your mind? All right, here we go. They don't fly very well because they're not tall enough to be pilots. They're not tall enough to be pilots. Penguins typically are small, right? They're not tall enough. They can't sit in that seat. They can't fly the plane, all right? So let's see what graphic that we have to support it. All right, so that penguin right here, take a look. It's going to try to fly. There we go. Not working out, and it's going all the way down, and it's falling, and then it somehow has some sort of parachute thing on top of its head, all right? So that penguin, not tall enough to fly, to be the pilot, but there's no plane there, all right? Let's see if I have a graphic that actually has a plane. There we go. That penguin is actually in a mini plane, so maybe he's tall enough to be able to fly the plane. I don't know. All right, that's McAvenue's joke of the day. Remember to share it with family and friends to get them to smirk, to get them to smile, and better yet, to get them to laugh. That is a good one. A penguin theme in December, a winter joke, perfect for the ST Math Challenge that we just started at the beginning of this week. So more jokes to come on the Friday edition. All right, we do have some good news to share. Fourth grade students in room 309 are now studying extreme weather, and take a look at those pictures of their of the students beginning their research project. Simply amazing, and they're working so hard, and I can't wait to see and hear all of the great work that they do focusing on extreme weather. And the funny thing is, we are going to talk about extreme weather at the end of this edition of Morning Announcements and what we might need to do if something happens that's extreme with the weather outside. All right. So perfect, perfect timing. All right. So let's put our celebration round of applause hands ready to go for these fourth grade students in room 309. All right. Keep those good news stories coming. I'd be happy to share them out on Morning Announcements as usual. And I do not have anything for the Friday edition. So teachers, please send something in to me before Friday and I will share it out. All right, here we go. So I wanted to remind everyone again, it's McAvenue's ST Math December Challenge, and it is a simple one. Increase your average class minutes from where you started on Monday, and we're going to keep working all the way through until December 17th, all right? So if you take a look right here, we still have 8 more days. So on our calendar, we've already completed some time on ST Math on December 6th and 7th, but if you actually count the number of penguins that are on the calendar still, you have 8 more days to continue to increase the number of minutes you're doing as a class. And if you notice, there's a celebration GG on the 22nd of December, because that is the day that we are going to celebrate the 2 classroom winners with a very special guest. And they're going to pick what they want to do on that particular day. It's going to be awesome. So it's not too late to increase your class minutes. So let's get moving on that one. All right. So here's an example and a little bit of an update. So only after 2 days of our challenge, 10 classrooms at McAvenue have already increased their average number of minutes that they've been on ST Math. We have 3 more days this week. Let's see if we can even get more than 10 classes by the Friday edition of Morning Announcements. I will share out an update. Maybe we can have 15 classes increase their minutes. We'll see, but I'll provide another update with how everyone's doing. So nice job, everyone. I'm so excited for this ST Math Challenge. So great. And take a look at Gigi. He's got his McAvenue hat on and holding up a McAvenue sign. Gotta love that. All right, awesome. All right, just another reminder, Friday, there's another edition of McAvenue's Spirit Friday, and it's going to be holiday sweater and shirt day. Remember, it doesn't have to be ugly, but it should be holiday. It can be something that you make. It could be something that's red and green. It might not have to be red and green, but it has to have something to do with the holiday season. I'm going to leave it up to you to be as creative as possible. I know that I have a few choices that I have to make before Friday, but I will pick something really special to wear to school for that day. So don't forget and mark your calendars, everyone. All right. It's right. It's Friday, December 10th, just to let you know the number date for that. All right. When you see that blank teal screen, you know it's time to talk about McAvenue's core values. That's right. We're talking about respect. We're talking about responsibility, and we're talking about safety. All right. So today's core value challenge is going to focus on safety. I need everyone to make safe decisions at this school to be as safe as possible at all times at McAvenue. What I'm noticing still is that kids are moving far too fast throughout the building. And I'm not going to say that they're running, but they're almost running. All right. So what we need to do is have walking feet at all times at our school. I'm going to be on the lookout for that today. Mr. A is going to be on the lookout for that today. And I know your teachers are going to remind you that you need to be walking at all times at McAvenue, including on the stairs. All right. So give me a double thumbs up if you think you can do that McAvenue core value safety challenge for today. Awesome. And remember, when we put respect, responsibility, and safety together, we typically make McAvenue the best school that we all know. We're going to see that graphic at the very end. But since we're focusing on safety, I wanted to kind of review one thing with everybody quickly. So what I want to focus on is something that's called severe weather. So severe weather is not just like a snowstorm that might cancel school. There's a time that we could be in school and there could be like, you never know. I mean, it's not likely to happen, but there could be a time where there's a hurricane. There could be a time where there's a tornado or super strong winds that might put our school at risk. What I mean is by staying in the classroom may not be the safest spot, and we may have to make a decision at a school so that we can be as prepared as possible if we have to say, listen, it is crazy outside and we need to make sure that we have to keep everybody safe until that storm passes. All right. We call that severe weather, and it could be a lot of different things that might happen at McAvenue. It is not often that it happens. I can tell you right now, in my 27 years in education, I don't think I've ever had to actually do this with students ever, but it's always good to practice. So what I wanted to let everybody know, the spot that we would all go to as a school is the first floor, which is really where the cafeteria is and the second grade classrooms in the gymnasium. And we would be lining ourselves all around the hallway, including in the gymnasium, in a certain position. We'd be up against the wall in this position right here. It's called the tuck position, when we're on our knees, our heads down, and our hands are over our head, all right? That's the position that everybody would be in, and we would be facing the wall when we would do that, all right? Now, if we ever have to go downstairs, there's going to be a lot of organization that we're going to have to do on the fly, where we're going to be telling classrooms where to go and organizing it as things are unfolding. But this is the position, boys and girls, that I want you to be aware of, and I want you to practice today. This is exactly what you would be doing, all right? This would not be something that you would do in the classroom. This would be something that if there's an alert, and I make an announcement and say, everybody needs to go to the first floor. Now we have a severe weather emergency. You would go downstairs. We would tell you where to go. You would go up against the wall in that position downstairs. All right. So I want you to practice that today. And teachers will talk to you about, you know, when that could happen and how we would go down to the first floor as safe as possible. And you don't have to practice, but it's just an opportunity to talk about it, all right? Wanted to share that out with everyone, just so that you're aware. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'd be happy to come to the classroom to talk to your class about that. But that is it, all right? So now we have an opportunity to make McAvenue the best school that we all know. Let's do our fist bump sign out. Get your fist up. Let's turn it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. So go get them today. Work hard today. Laugh today. Smile today. Enjoy your early release day. Remember your safety challenge. Talk about severe weather emergency and what we would have to do on the first floor at McAvenue in that position I just showed. And that really is it. Don't forget, it's ugly shirt, or not ugly shirt. It's holiday shirt. Holiday sweater. It could be ugly on Friday. Don't forget about that. All right. So that's it from me. You'll catch up with me with another edition of McAvenue's morning announcements on Friday. Take it easy, everybody. Be well. See ya.